it is. Phew. Ow! It can't be overheating. It's not even on.
I'm the one overheating. Your laptop's been in the sun for hours. Of course it's gonna be hot.
I know it's warm out, Sam, but how does all that heat get into my laptop?
Well, heat is just thermal energy.
I thought heat was temperature.
Temperature is a measurement of heat. Like today, the high temperature tells us there's a lot of thermal energy in the air. Low temperature means there's less energy. Heat itself is the energy.
Okay, so if my laptop is hot, that means it has a lot of energy?
Kinda. All matter is made up of particles. The faster the particles move, the more thermal energy, or heat, something has.
Where does all that energy come from in the first place?
It's always there. Energy can't be created or destroyed, but it's constantly moving around the universe, in and out of different matter. Heat is transferred in three different ways: radiation, conduction, and convection.
But which one is responsible for burning my hand?
Let's talk about radiation first. Radiation is the transfer of heat through electromagnetic waves that move through space.
Sun rays?
Yup. The sun sends its heat right through the air. It doesn't need to touch anything to transfer its heat.
Well, I sure can feel it.
Yeah, you can. When heat is transferred by radiation, it moves from one object to the next without having them touch.
Oh, yeah. I can feel the heat without even touching it.
Now, when you do touch the laptop...
Not doing that again.
Okay, but when you did touch it, heat was transferred in a different way, directly from the laptop to your hand. That's called conduction.
So conduction transfers heat between things that touch.
Yep, when conduction happens, heat is always transferred from the hot to the cool object. The particles in the hot object are moving faster than those in the cold object. When the objects touch, the cooler object's particles get pushed and start moving faster, and it warms up.
Sounds like heat is contagious. How come when I touch the grass right next to my laptop, it's not as hot? It's been sitting in the sun, too.
Good question. Some objects are good conductors. They let heat pass through them very easily. Your laptop is metal, and metal is an excellent conductor. The grass we're standing on is an insulator, the opposite of a conductor. Insulators are difficult for heat to move through, so they stay cooler.
Thank goodness. It's so hot today. Know what sounds good?
A dip in your pool?
You said it. But wait, how come the water in my pool stays so cool?
Sometimes heat is reflected or bounced back. The pool water reflects the sun's rays, just like the water in lakes and oceans all over the world.
Ugh! This water's warm. What happened to reflection?
That's convection for you. The transfer of heat through a liquid or gas.
But the water's inside this bottle.
Sometimes convection works along with conduction. The water started out cool, but through conduction and radiation, your hand and the sun have warmed it. Both transferred heat to the bottle and warmed it up. Then the heat from the bottle was transferred to the water. The movement of the water then spread the heat around until all of it is warm. When heat moves through water or gas, it's called convection. Same thing happens when you heat soup or water for tea on the stove.
Two things I'm definitely not going to be doing today. Okay, so heat is different from temperature then. It's the amount of thermal energy that exists in matter, while temperature is a measurement of the amount of thermal energy within an object. An object that has little thermal energy has a low temperature, and vice versa. Heat is always being transferred in one of three ways: radiation, conduction, and convection. And it's always moving from warmer objects to cooler objects. That said, I say we make like the heat and transfer our warm, sweaty selves into that cool pool of mine.
I'll race you there.